This example asks us to find the domain and range of f of x equals negative square root of 25 minus x squared. And this example drives students crazy, but instructors love it because it's so elegant. Let's take a look at why that is. Let's start with quick definition of domain and range. Domain is the x values, range is the y values. In this specific example and other ones like it, this jumps out as a very specific form. And let's look at it geometrically. So that's the weird thing about this. Instead of viewing it analytically and trying to figure out where all this stuff inside the radical is greater than zero, which is what students tend to do, and that's actually pretty hard to unpack, though you can do it, but then you have a problem with the y values, that becomes challenging. Let's look at this geometrically rather than analytically. So recall the equation for a circle. Right? Let's do it like this. X squared plus y squared equals r squared. How about if we choose 25? That gives us a circle of radius 5. Right? Now if we solve this for y, so y squared equals 25, see where this is going, minus x squared, and then y equals plus or minus square root of 25 minus x squared. Okay, and so what we have here in this function, it's a half circle, and it's the lower part of a half circle. So let's graph this thing out. Okay, there's my set of axes, and I'm only going to graph the lower half. I know my radius is 5, so this will be out to 5. This will be down to 5. This will be 5 to the left. Whoops, 5. And it looks something like this. There we go, our half circle. Might be helpful to label our axes, x and y. And now from the image, we can quickly find the domain and the range. Right, the domain is the x values. So let's go from negative 5 to 5, and it's going to include those endpoints. Negative 5 to 5, and the range is, of course, the y values. And that's going to go from negative 5, we're just going up the y-axis here, goes negative 5 up to 0, and then include 0 and stops. Right, so domain and range, very quick, very elegant to find geometrically or graphically. If you try to do it analytically, it's going to be quite the morass, and I don't recommend doing it that way.